What's up, Vikings? My name is Fernando.
And I'm Elias. Welcome back to Viking Vision.
Don't forget that the 11th we spring forward, so be sure to set your clock an hour ahead. Even though you lose an hour of sleep on Sunday, you'll be able to sleep in every Tuesday of this month starting the 13th. Recently, there has been heartbreaking news about the school shootings happening across the country. Students have now taken a stand in Florida and across the nation against gun violence.
So on March 14th, we have a national walkout that's been planned across the country. And what we did as a district is we looked at, for our three high schools, coming up with a bell schedule that would allow students to exercise their right and have a voice on that day. So on the 14th, we've created a window of time at 10 a.m. for the students that want to be a part of the national walkout that's happening. And it's against school violence. So we've created a schedule on that day for that. So during the walkout, we have a couple ideas of where they'll meet, but we feel like we're leaning towards, as an admin team, we're leaning towards having the meeting site be on the football field, the new turf football field. And our plan is to set up a stage at the 50-yard line. And we have some of our student leaders that are putting together something that's a little more organized, where we will honor the 17 victims of the shooting in Florida. And so they're kind of coming up with their details, but from what they've told us, it's going to be pretty powerful. And we also have a letter writing activity that our Renaissance is going to be helping us with, so we can write direct letters to students in Florida. For students that are not going to be part of that movement, what we've done is we've taken our regular break as somewhere around 10 minutes and then a passing period. So this day on the break will be a little bit longer. So they'll be able to be in the quad or, you know, go to the student store, get breakfast as normal. They'll just be a little bit longer break for them. I think what will happen on that day and the stance that's taken and what comes out of it is really going to depend on how the students put it forward. So we feel like in our position, it's more of the facilitating the ability for your voice to be heard.
It is truly inspiring to see these teens take the initiative and fight against gun violence. We hope to see you Vikings during the walkout.
Our district has a lot to offer, from dual immersion programs to career pathways. Covina Valley District is one of the first to offer coding that starts in kindergarten. Today we take a look at Sierra Vista Middle School's Code to the Future program.
Through Code to the Future, Sierra Vista Middle School is teaching coding in their everyday science classes, preparing students for the 21st century workforce. Technology is being used in everyday classes, and with the use of coding, students will be prepared for the increase in future STEM careers.
Now that I see, you know, technology incorporated on a daily basis, I think kids are excited to come to school and they want to learn and, you know, just be a part of what's become part of our 21st century learning.
The benefits of implementing a coding program at the middle school level truly are numerous. One, probably the most important, is engagement. It gives kids a reason to come to school and excitement about school. They might not connect in other academic areas, but they certainly connect to coding. That's something that they want to do. It helps them with critical thinking, which is our focus here at Sierra Vista. So the kids are challenged every single day to work through problems and apply their content knowledge in a new venue, which is coding.
At the middle school level, we use Minecraft EDU and connection with code.org to actually allow students to code their various projects and stuff. I believe that students who are getting the opportunity to code here at Sierra Vista are really being given a huge edge. The really neat thing is the fact that we have one-on-one devices, and students, you know, they don't need to worry about parents being able to afford a computer for them or anything like that. We provide those for the kids. And then we also provide, you know, the coding programs and low cost Wi-Fi or, you know, home internet if needed. And so these kids are really being given an opportunity that other districts haven't provided. And I believe that it's really going to set them up for future jobs.
Students that don't have plans initially to go to college and go right into the workforce really are going to benefit from coding. For the most part, it teaches them problem solving, critical thinking, and really perseverance. They really need to start working through problems and gives them the confidence to know that they can do anything.
I believe that coding is going to provide a lot of career opportunities for our kids. Things from data analysts to computer programmers, even maybe being a teacher. You know, you look at our kids right now, and my kids are 12 years old. They're still, 8 to 10 years away from obtaining a career. And so at that point, who knows which jobs may exist. But I know that if kids want to be successful and obtain good paying jobs, that's probably where the money's going to be and where they'll be able to, have a good life.
Not only does Sierra Vista have a successful Code to the Future program, they're also recognized as a school to watch by the California League of Middle Schools.
One of Northview's very own, Chris Rosenblum, worked on a film which has been nominated for an Academy Award.
I always loved movies ever since I was really young. I think the one that really sparked my interest was The Dark Knight. I was just so encapsulated by the performances, cinematography, and directing. Persistence contributes to my success. This industry is very cutthroat in that it won't wait for you, and it honestly doesn't care who you are because there's 1,000 people waiting for your job that are probably better. I had a friend that went to USC, and one day he's like, hey, I have this short film coming up that I want you to help out with. I just came off of a movie and I was kind of exhausted. I really didn't want to do it, but I'm the type of guy that thinks in the back of my head, who are the people that I could meet with this? And the knowledge that I could attain. We were all shocked. I got a call from Chris saying that, hey, we got nominated and all that. And I was like, what? The most rewarding project that I've done is my short film, Copper, that I directed. I'm gonna continue to direct. I'm partnered with an app company called Everybody Digital, and it's kind of like Netflix for short films. And I have, aspirations. I've written multiple scripts and that I want to shoot. So we'll see where it goes, though.
Congratulations, Chris. We look forward to seeing you at the Oscars.
What's up, Vikings? I'm David.
And I'm Savannah, and welcome back to VVSN.
I'm running out of time. Every day goes by so fast. And every moment counts, baby, I don't want to miss a thing. We can sleep under the stars, we can sleep under the stars, or hang out in hotel bars, driving somewhere in your car. We can sleep under the stars, we can sleep under the stars, under the stars.
On the weekend of February 24th, six of our varsity wrestling boys qualified for state at Masters. Congratulations to Bobby Pinto, Gabriel Cortez, Andrew Alamo, Brando Reynoso, David Barilla, and four-time consecutive champion Eddie Flores.
In the same weekend, the girls wrestled in Visalia for the CIF state tournament. Congratulations to Angelina Gomez for winning first place in the state tournament for the second year in a row, and Julia Padilla for placing second.
Our Viking cheerleaders took on a new division at the 2018 USA Spirit Nationals Co-Ed Varsity Intermediate. They competed in a challenging battle against 14 other teams and placed second. We are very proud of you.
Our first ever home swim meet was in our new pool on Wednesday, February 28th against Edgewood. Remember to come out and support our track and field team against Covina and South Hills tomorrow at District Field at 3:15.
On March 7th, our JV and freshman baseball team will be playing against Glendora at 3:15. Good luck, Vikings. On March 8th at 3:15, our varsity softball team plays Ontario Christian at home for the season opener. Good luck, ladies. Get that win. That's all for sports. Have a good one, Vikes.
Now to Giselle for special segments.
Hey, Vikings. This is Giselle, your special segment anchor. The Saturday school dates for March are the 10th, 17th, and 24th. Seniors, make sure to clear your hours. This month, Renaissance is holding its first Mr. Northview pageant. If you are interested, juniors or seniors, be sure to sign up in the Pequod during brunch or lunch. The deadline is this Friday, March 9th. The winner will receive a prom ticket and a free tux rental. Be sure to watch the next Viking Vision for more information.
Thanks for tuning into this episode.
And remember, Vikings, good life.
Good life. Catch you later.
A gunman walking into an Oregon high school, heading straight for that locker room, opening fire.
It was a room full of teenagers, then suddenly full of gunfire.
There were 15 kids in that classroom.
The site today of a mass shooting, and this time, gunfire aimed at elementary school children.
This horrible high school shooting.
Broward County Sheriff says at least 17 people are dead.
Since Columbine, there's been 270 school shootings in the U.S. alone.
And since 2013, there has been an average of one school shooting per week in the U.S.
And enough is enough.
Students all across the nation are coming together to protest never again.
And on March 24th in Washington, D.C., we will be your voice at the March of Our Lives movement.
But we need your support. Let us be your voice.
All of us, together, will pledge never again.